So you're wanting really to know, like, how do I prepare songs? How do I get ready for an event or church services? All of that. And my approach has always been to honor the music. All my students and people at seminars hear that phrase, like, just honor the music, which really for me and many musicians means duplicate what you've heard on the recordings. And my students always hear this phrase, copy, copy, copy. Even when they get tired of, hearing that, like, no, learn the songs as if it was composed, as if it's a written drum part. And that kind of eliminates the question of what do I do with this song? And most leaders will like that, whether I've played in church services, touring bands, shows, whatever, they want to hear their music the way it was recorded. Now, that's a starting point. It doesn't have to be the finish, but as a musician, I've found it best to start there, copying what I've heard the other players do, and I'll even sketch it out. I'll do a little roadmap of the song. If there's a chart to be read, then I fill in the drum music on that chart. A lot of times it's just directional ideas. But once I've done that, I know I'm prepared to play the music the way the leader wants to hear it, and that's my primary job. And I think I've emphasized many times for players, you don't lose your own soul when you do that. You don't lose your expression because you're copying another drummer that you've heard on the recording. No, what you're doing is you're bringing that music to life again. So that's really how I look at that. And then if the music leader, the worship leader, the artist, if they want to hear more, they want to hear a new arrangement, new ideas, then I work on that too, try to explore my interpretation or kind of doing variations on the original ideas to make it more what they want to hear. So it really is musically correct and spiritually okay to kind of be good at both, be a good parrot, a copier, and really make this music yours. And then it's also good to be able to be creative and go beyond what was originally there. And both are very viable and both are important to develop as a musician. So yeah, in light of that, this idea of copying the music, a lot of times bands that are just playing together for fun, or especially in worship situations, you hear worship teams like, well, I just want to do my thing because that's worship, and nobody really does that. But I'm like, in classical music or in pop music, we want to hear it originally composed. Like if I'm playing Beethoven's Fifth Symphony as a drummer or as a percussionist playing the timpani part, I don't rewrite Beethoven. Or if I'm playing in a pop band and they want to hear their recording, I basically need to duplicate that because that brings that music to life. So when you hear your favorite music, the audience, well, they respond to that. And especially in symphonic music, when I played with orchestras, it was really trying to get the best interpretation of the written music. So that influenced me a lot as a drum set player, even playing freely and working on my own arrangements. And even playing for worship, that it became the rule to first learn it the way it was recorded or composed, and that becomes my starting point, and then I can go from there, very easily.